home Supersonic's XB-1 demonstration aircraft has successfully completed its test flights, signaling a significant leap toward the realization of its commercial supersonic airplane, the Overture. The Overture is expected to be constructed at a new facility in Greensboro, promising to revolutionize high-speed travel with environmentally sustainable practices. The inaugural flight took place at the Mojave Air and Space Port, California. A video was released by Boom showing XB-1 during takeoff, as well as flying above the desert landscape. That same airspace over Test Flight Valley has hosted many historic first flights in the past, including Bell's X-1, the North American X-15, and the Lockheed SR-71 Blackbird. XB-1 took flight in the same hallowed airspace where the Bell X-1 first broke the sound barrier in 1947. Blake Skoll, Boom founder and CEO, said, "I've been looking forward to this flight since founding Boom in 2014, and it marks the most significant milestone yet on our path to bring supersonic travel to passengers worldwide. In a major breakthrough for supersonic travel, Boom Supersonic has achieved a remarkable feat with the successful completion of test flights for its XB-1 demonstrator jet. This paves the way for the company's vision of a faster future as they progress towards building the Overture jet, which represents the pinnacle of speed, efficiency, and sustainability in the aviation industry. Designed to fly at twice the speed of traditional passenger jets, the Overture aspires to cut global travel times in half while adhering to stringent environmental criteria. Intent on fostering eco-friendly supersonic travel, Boom is committed to the use of sustainable aviation fuels to mitigate the climatic impact traditionally associated with high-speed air transport. According to Boom, XB-1 met all of its test objectives during its first flight, including safely and successfully achieving an altitude of 7,120 feet and speeds up to 238 knots, 273 miles per hour, or Mach 0.355. Flight tracking data shows that the aircraft flew for under 30 minutes in total. While XB-1 was in the air, the team performed an initial assessment of the aircraft's handling qualities, including airspeed checks with the T-38 Chase aircraft and assessing the aircraft's stability in the landing attitude at a high angle of attack, the company further notes. The aircraft was flown by Chief Test Pilot Biddle Doc Shoemaker, who said the following of today's events: "Everyone on the XB-1 team should be incredibly proud of this achievement. It has been a privilege to share this journey with so many dedicated and talented professionals. The experience we have gained in reaching this milestone will be invaluable to Boom's revival of supersonic travel." Test pilot Tristan Geppetto Brandenburg, who flew the T-38 Chase aircraft that monitored XB-1 in the air, said, "Being in the air with XB-1 during its maiden flight is a moment I will never forget. The team has been working hard to get to this point, and seeing today's flight through mission completion is a huge accomplishment for all of us." XB-1, which the Warzone has previously written about, measures 62.6 feet long and features an elongated delta wing platform with a wingspan of 21 feet. The demonstrator leverages state-of-the-art technologies in order to enable efficient supersonic flight, including carbon fiber composites, advanced avionics, digitally optimized aerodynamics, and an advanced supersonic propulsion system, Boom highlights. Its propulsion system comprises three General Electric J8515 turbojets, the same as what's found in the F-5 Freedom Fighter, which collectively provide more than 12,000 pounds of thrust. XB-1 is expected to have a top speed of around Mach 2.2 to 1,687.99 miles per hour. Now that its first flight has been conducted, Boom is set to expand XB-1's flight envelope in order to confirm its performance and handling qualities through and beyond Mach 1. Shoemaker will once again be in the cockpit for the first supersonic flight when this occurs. Of course, the achievement represents a huge milestone for the company, and particularly for its future Overture supersonic airliner. Overture will measure 201 feet from nose to tail, and theoretically be able to achieve cruising speeds of Mach 1.7 to 1,304 miles per hour, at a maximum speed of Mach 2.2. It will, according to Boom, have a maximum range of 4,500 nautical miles. The Boom Supersonic XB-1 is more than a high-speed jet. It represents a resurgence of supersonic travel with the potential to revolutionize the way we connect across continents. As testing and development continue, the aerospace community and passengers alike await a new chapter in aviation history. The Supersonic XB-1 is a technological marvel developed by Boom Technology, aiming to become the first independent American aircraft to break the sound barrier in decades. This prototype is a demonstrator for Overture, a supersonic passenger airliner designed to make global travel faster and more efficient. The XB-1 leverages advanced aerodynamics and materials to pave the way for the next generation of commercial supersonic flight. In terms of defense-related interest, the company has been working with the U.S. Air Force since 2020 to explore a configuration of Overture intended specifically for government executive flight. The rapid transit of cargo, as well as personnel transport, could well constitute future Air Force uses of Overture. In July 2022, Northrop Grumman and Boom announced a collaboration to develop a variant of the future Overture supersonic airliner specifically for the US and allied military forces. As Boom highlighted, that variant could well provide the military with the speed needed to execute rapid response missions. Fitted with specialized capabilities, the aircraft could be used to deliver medical supplies, provide for emergency medical evacuation, or surveil vast areas faster than conventional aircraft, the company noted. The special mission Overture variant could also be used to coordinate other aircraft and ground assets in a variety of scenarios. Of course, this isn't the first time in recent memory that potential commercial supersonic aircraft could be useful for military applications. Back when Lockheed Martin announced that it was working with Aerion to develop the AS-2 supersonic business jet, which has since gone defunct, in 2017, we outlined the various ways in which its capabilities could be harnessed by the US military, which you can read more about here. On the commercial side, Overture will supposedly accommodate a total of 64 to 80 passengers, with the aim of making supersonic travel more affordable to greater numbers of travelers. The aircraft itself is designed to be profitable for airlines at fares similar to first and business class across hundreds of transoceanic routes. The company's website notes, in theory offering business class fares at a fraction of the cost of tickets to board the Anglo-French Concorde, which was retired from commercial supersonic flight in late 2003. Each aircraft will cost $200 million to produce, Boom has claimed in the past. It states on its website that Overture's order book stands at 130 orders and pre-orders, with commitments from American Airlines, United Airlines, and Japan Airlines. Overture is slated to roll out in 2026, begin test flights in 2027, and is expected to receive type certification by 2029. An end goal that Boom has targeted for several years at this point. However, this timeline is very much subject to a huge number of different factors going right for the company and is extremely ambitious. Whether or not Boom ultimately sticks to this schedule, or anything resembling it, the first flight of XB-1 marks an important step towards making the company's vision of commercial supersonic flight a reality. If you enjoy content like this, please go ahead and like and subscribe to this video, because I appreciate all your support.